accused of abusing his ex-girlfriend's kitten. That cat survived. But as NBC2's Jennifer Vegas found out, the kitten before that was not as lucky.
Well, Peter, tonight, Luis Heron is facing two counts of aggravated animal cruelty. Today, he made his first appearance in court. A judge called these allegations, quote, horrendous, and says he's a danger to the community. Jail today.
We finally got justice for Ruby and for Hunter and all the other kittens that they did have.
Rachel Lohr, Heron's girlfriend's former best friend, says it was a journey to get here, telling us one of those three victims is still alive tonight. The bone-chilling saga beginning last March, when Heron and his girlfriend took in a litter of four stray kittens.
Those kittens wouldn't live more than a few months before they would mysteriously die.
Fast forward to July, Lohr helped Heron's girlfriend adopt this four-month-old kitten, naming it Hunter. She says Heron's girlfriend was living with him.
After a while, she called me up and said, he's having seizures. I don't know what's going on. He won't move. He's not moving.
Taking him to the vet, learning Hunter needed to be put down. In October, Heron's girlfriend adopted another cat, naming it Ruby. Like deja vu for Lohr, it didn't take long for Ruby's health to decline. His girlfriend texting her,
saying that she believed that Lewis was abusing her. That's when it sort of clicked. Oh my God. He is doing this. This is going on.
It didn't take long for the Naples Cat Alliance to then step in.
She had 9 broken ribs, a broken tail, a collapsed lung lobe.
Calling the Collier County Sheriff's Office. Last night, more than 6 months later, Heron was arrested at his job.
Now, and I'm really hoping that he gets the full extent of whatever is coming to him.
A judge set his bond at $100,000. Now tonight, CCSO also confirms with us that Luis Heron is a documented member of a street gang. I'm live in Collier County, Jennifer Vegas, NBC2.